Hello, my name is Misty and I am with crazyaboutteaching.blogspot.com. Today, I want to kind of talk about one of the websites that I have been using in my first grade class. It is skypeintheclassroom.com. And my assistant principal found this post, I think it was on Twitter, and she called me. She goes, "You've got to check this out because we're doing a technology showcase in our school. And I'm one of the teachers that they will be coming and observing, so I decided I would check it out." So what I did was I have an account on Skype in the classroom, but I also have a Skype account. Both are free, and I ended up joining both of the accounts together. So now I could just log in and everything is connected. What you can do when you're in Skype in the classroom is you can find a lesson. So at the top right here where you're looking, this is actually my profile. And you can find a lesson that is a lesson that has already been done, maybe Reader's Theater. You can look. Let me see, I'm gonna click right quick. And you could choose your subject, your age group. And what's great about that is you can kind of filter what you want and what you don't want. And I am in one of the reading theater groups with another teacher. What I did was just ask to join, and then she emailed me back. And then we were kind of communicating. We're picking out a book, and then we're going to read it individually, and then we're going to read it together and kind of partner up with that through Skype. Also, another thing, you can actually find a certain teacher. What we have done as well is we did Mystery Skype, and what that kind of is we will Skype with another classroom and we try to guess where the other class is from. And we Skyped with another fourth grade classroom, and it actually was not that bad because I kind of helped them out a little bit. But overall, they would ask the fourth grade class questions, they would ask us. I had the United States map up on my Promethean board, so they would be able to kind of look and see because we do talk about social living, but in geography in first grade, not so much. So, but it was really, really fun. The fourth graders were very patient with us, and all I did was just find somebody. Just go to Mystery Skype right here, where the tab that I'm pointing at right now, and the rest of it is easy. You can kind of pick what you want, or this teacher actually contacted me through email and asked if we wanted to Skype. Also, the best, I think, one of the best things that we have is I go all the way down, and you can go to Skype in the classroom actual website. This is my profile, but you can also go there and see where it says guest speakers. And this is where you find the actual published children's authors and also other professionals that you would like to speak to your classroom. And I'm going to kind of click over if I can, and I'm going to show you. This is just an example. This is actually my blog, and this is one of the Skypes. This was a third Skype with Brianna Kaplan Sayers, our first grade class. Skyped with her. She was so awesome. She put on a crown, she put on different hats. She read this new book right here that she had out, and she was very animated. She let the kids ask her questions. We also had this author right here. I hate to butcher his last name, so I'm going to say Paul. And he made all of the Munster books. Actually, he read Monster Needs a Party and Seaver the Weaver. He read those to us before they were actually released to be sold. So I was talking to them, my class, how important that was, how neat that was. And he also let them ask some questions about how to write a book, what did he need to do to write the book, how did he get the pictures illustrated. So it was really fun, and the kids really learned. And after that, we ended up making our own stories and our own books. So I think that Skype in the classroom, it's free, it's fun, it takes 30 minutes out of your day to Skype with another classroom or actually another author. So we had a blast with that. So I hope.